Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, my dear students, here is your mathematics teacher Muhammad Anjaz Saeed from Pakistan International School, Taiz, Saudi Arabia. Today we will continue our lecture number 39 and class 10, exercise 7.2. Actually, we have solved so many questions from different exercises of chapter number 7, but due to revised reduced syllabus, some questions are added. For example, in exercise 7.2, question number 2, part 2 is included now. Similarly, question number 5 and question number 10. So we have question number 2. We have to find value of L. After that, theta is equal to 60 degree 30 minutes and R is equal to 15 millimeter. Remember that you know we have L is equal to R theta and area of sector is half R square theta. Basically, these are two formulas. L is equal to R theta. This formula is used to find the length of arc. This R is the radius of circle. Theta is the radian measure of angle. Remember that theta is radian measure of angle. Similarly, we have area of sector is equal to half R square theta. Similarly, the relation between the radian and degree, this is pi radian is equal to 180 degrees. I told you, if you want to find in radians, that will be 180 over pi degrees. And similarly, if you want to find 1 degree, that is pi over 180 radians. This is approximately, 1 radian is approximately 57.3 degrees. And 1 degree is equal to pi over 180 radian, its numerical value is 0.01745. So, if you simplify these numbers, you will get these answers. So, these are the conversion from radian to degrees and degrees to radian. Here, you know that 60 degree plus 30 over 60 degree. Remember that if you want to convert minutes into degrees, you have to divide by 60. And if you have in seconds, then second will also be divided by 60 to convert it to minutes, and minutes are converted into degrees. So here is 60 plus 0.5 degree. So this is 60.5 degree. So 60.5 multiplied by 0.01745. Remember that this is DMS system. Degrees are converted into radians by multiplying with pi over 180, rather pi over 180 or 0.01745. So we can find its value as 60.5 multiplied by 0.01745. Dear students, this will be equal to 1.0557 radians. Now we have to find the length of arc using L is equal to R theta and apply the value of R as 15 millimeter multiplied by theta is 1.0557. So here we will get multiplied by 15. So we get this is 15.8358 millimeters. This is your answer. Dear students, that was very easy and we have already solved this question, in fact. After that, we have question number 5. Same exercise, question number 5. What is given here? You can check that. This is basically the conversion rules, 0.01745. Okay. Here we have, in a circle of radius 10 meter, find the distance traveled by the point moving on this circle if the point makes 3.5 revolutions. Question number 5. Radius of circle is 10 meter. Radius is equal to 10 meter. This is the circle. One revolution mean one round trip. So one revolution is equal to 2 pi radians. Remember that one revolution is equal to 2 pi radian, and in this way we can find theta is equal to 3.5 revolution. 3.5 revolution. Remember that 3.5 multiplied by 1 revolution is 2 pi radians. So multiplied by 2 pi radians. Here is 3.5 into 2 is 7 pi radians. Dear students, actually it is given in your book as a hint. But they have written this directly. 3.5 revolution is equal to 7 pi radian. But how we got that? Actually, one revolution is 2 pi radian. This is conversion. From revolution to radian, then we can get that. And we have to find length of arc using the formula L is equal to R theta. R is 10 meter and theta is 7 pi radians. Here is 70 pi radians. So it will be now, this is 7 pi meter, 70 into 3.147. Pi mean 3.147. We will multiply that. Here, 70 multiplied by 3.147, and we got 220. 220 meter is your required answer. After that, we have part number 10. Find area of sector whose central angle is 20 degree, radius is 7 meter. Question number 10, radius is given, that is 7 meter, and theta is equal to 20 degree, and we have to find area of sector. Remember that we have to find area of sector. So dear students, we have this formula, A is equal to half r square theta. Remember that first of all you have to convert this degree into radians. Degree into radian mean 0.01745. Actually 20 is multiplied by pi over 180. So pi over 180 is this one, so you can multiply directly with that number. No problem. That is same thing. Here is 0.01745 multiplied by 20. That is 0.349. Using area is equal to half r square theta. Half r square mean, that is 7 meter square, theta is 0.349. That will be equal to can have 0.349 multiplied by 7 square divided by 2. So we can get 8.55 meter square, that is area of sector. Now, dear students, we have exercise 7.1. There were so many questions we have solved already. For example, question number 4 and question number 5. We have finished that. Now, the addition in exercise 7.1 is question number 1, part 2, 3, and 6, 8. Similarly, in question number 8, express sexagesimal system into decimal form. Actually, we have to convert DMS system into decimal form. Remember that here is exercise 7.1. Dear students, after chapter number 7, I have already finished this chapter number 7, but I was revising that due to revised syllabus. So I was adding these questions to your syllabus, which we are already finished. So after chapter number 7, I am going to start chapter number 8. Because in this way you will have the test, and if there is a test, then you must follow the board pattern of your paper. So we need some theorems also, some practical geometry portion also. So don't worry, I will complete afterward chapter number 6, 5 on addition and questions. Don't worry, I will do that. But I want to complete first in that portion, which is the practical geometry portion and theorem portion also. So don't worry, you will do it, but I am trying to complete your paper pattern so that there will be easy for making us the paper for your coming tests also, okay? So 7.1 exercise. In exercise 7.1, we have, remember that, exercise 7.1, locate the falling angles. Location of falling angle mean, actually, we have, this is first quadrant, second, third, and this is fourth. Remember that these are quadrantal angles. What are the quadrantal angles? Here is 0, this is 90, 180, 270, and 360. These are quadrantal angles. So any angle which will be in between 0 and 90, it will be in first quadrant. So that is the question. For example, locate the following angles. Question number 1, part 2. Question number 1, part 2, 22.5 degrees. So dear students, you can check. This may be 22.5 degrees. It will be in first quadrant between 0 and 90. This is the location. Simple location of the angle. Similarly, in case of minus 120, 135, second part is 135. Remember, where is 135? It is located between 90 and 180. This is 135. Here. This will be, and taken from the positive side of the angle, from the zero position. So it is 135 in second quadrant. Similarly, in case of part number 6, this is minus 120. Remember that if you go anti-clockwise, angles are positive, anti-clockwise. But in case of clockwise, angles are negative. If this is 0, this will be minus 90, and here is minus 180, this will be minus 270. After complete rotation in clockwise, you will have minus 360. Dear students, if they are given angle of minus 120, definitely angle minus 120 is in between minus 90 and minus 180. Here will be 120. This one. Remember that this is minus 90, here will be minus 30. So total will be minus 120. Remember that total is from zero position, you move clockwise, angle is minus 90, next is minus 30, total is minus 120. So minus 120 degree lies in the third quadrant. So dear students, you must know, in case of positive angles, you have to move anti-clockwise. In case of negative angles, you have to move clockwise. After that, we have question number 2. Express the following DMS measure into decimal form. Remember that question number 2 part 1. Question number 2 part 1. 45 degree and 30 minutes. Remember that 1 degree is equal to 60 minutes. 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds. 1 degree is equal to 60 minutes. 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds. So we have to convert minutes into degree by dividing with 60. It will become minutes, degrees also. Minutes are divided by 60 to become degrees. And seconds are divided to by 60 to become minutes, in fact. So here is 45 degree and divide this. 0, 0 cancels out. This will be 1 over 2. 1 over 2 is 0.5. So 45.5 degree. That's your answer in decimal. After that, we have second part. Second part is 60 degree, 30 minutes, 30 seconds. Second part, 60 degree, 30 minutes, 30 seconds. Dear students, first of all, you will write down 60 degree, 30 minutes, and what will be that? 30 divided by 60, this second becomes minutes. Clear? Here is 30 minute plus 0.5 minutes. 60 plus 30.5 minutes. Remember that we are going to convert second into minutes and minutes into degrees now. So 60 plus 30.5 divided by 60, and now minutes are converted into degrees. So 60 degree plus 30.5 divided by 60. 30.5 divided by 60. That will be 0.50833. So you can add them, 60.508333. These are the values in terms of decimal. Dear students, after that, question number 3. Question number 3. Now this is the reverse process. Here was DMS converting in decimal form. In question number 3, decimals are given, you have to convert into DMS system. Degree, minute, second system. Degree, minute, second system. This is known as DMS system. In question number 3, we will write down decimals into DMS system. Decimals into DMS system. Here is question number 3, part number 2. Question number 3, part 2. We are given 125.45 degrees. Dear students, now you can check. You have 125 degrees complete and 0.45 degrees in decimal. Again, 125.45 degrees mean 125 degree complete and 0.45 degrees in decimal. So 125 degree, 0.45 degree, this will be multiplied by 60 to convert minutes. Remember that 1 degree is equal to 60 minutes. So 0.45 degree will be equal to 0.45 multiplied by 60. So here 125 degree complete, and we can use calculator here. 0.45, yes, 0.45 multiplied by 60. So 0.45 multiplied by 60 is 27 minutes. Remember that if this is 27 minutes, then in case of BMS system, you will have 0 seconds. 0 seconds. Dear students, we have finished our part number 2. Similarly, question number 3, part 5, we have -67.58. -67.58 degrees. Same pattern, same technique. You have -67 degree, 0.58 degrees. -67 degrees. Now degrees are converted into minutes by multiplying with 60. 0.58 multiplied by 60. Now this is not degree now. This is minute. -67 degree and 0.58 multiplied by 60, we have 34.8 minutes. Dear students, check that 0.458 multiplied by 60, we have 34.8 minutes. -67 degree, 34 minutes are complete minutes and 0.8 minutes are in decimal. After that, -67 degree, 34 minutes complete, 0.8 minutes multiplied by 60 to convert into seconds. 34.8 degree means minutes mean 34 complete minutes, 0.8 minutes. These minutes are converted into seconds by multiplying with 60. -67 degree, 34 minutes, and this will be 48 seconds. Dear students, this was your angle in decimal, and here this angle is in BMS system. Degree, minutes, and seconds. I hope that you understood this question. Similarly, we can have question number 5. Addition. There are some addition. Part number 2, 5, and 7. So I am taking part number 7. I'm taking part number 7. Some parts you have to do by yourself, my dear students. They are not so difficult. I have already touched these questions and solved. And I have solved these new questions maximum so that you may have better idea about them. Question number 5, 7th part. Question number 5, 7th part is minus 7 pi over 8. 7 pi over 8. These are in radians. So you have to convert them into degrees. Remember that minus 7 pi over 8, these are radians. So radians are converted into degrees by multiplying with 180 over pi. So pi cancelled out, and we have minus 7 into 180 divided by 8. Minus 7 multiplied by 180. So over minus 1260 divided by 8, that will be 157.5 degrees. So dear students, 157.5 degrees. Actually, we have to convert this in DMS system. A radian was given and you have to find in degrees. So here is 157 degrees and 0.5 multiplied by 60 minutes. So 157 degree and you multiply, that will be 30 minutes. So dear students, this was your question number 5, part number 7. Here is another type, question number, part number 5. 5 is 3. Basically, this is 3 radian. And you can multiply into degrees as 180 over pi. 180 over pi, 3 multiplied by 180, pi means 3.147. So here is 3 multiplied by 180, that will be divided by 3.147, that is equal to 171.59, this one. Dear students, that was 3 radian. Actually, you know, 1 radian is equal to 57.3 degrees. Definitely 3 radian multiplied by that and you will get this one. After that, 171 degree, 0.59 multiplied by 60, it becomes minutes. So we have, remember, 171 degree, 0.59 multiplied by 60, that is 35.4 minutes. 171 degree, 35 minutes complete, 0.4 minutes in decimal. 171 degree, 35 minutes, 0.4 into 60, they are seconds now. 171 degree, 35 minutes, that will be 24 seconds. Dear students, that was your answer. I hope that you understood this question and you can solve the parts which I left for you. And most of the questions I have solved in the revision, in the revised reduced syllabus, and chapter number 7 is finished. So dear students, after that we have
miscellaneous exercise 7. In case of miscellaneous exercise, you must know about these MCQs. Question number 1 and question number 3 are given. The union of two non-collinear rays which have common endpoint is called, your correct option is A, an angle. The system of measurement in which the angle is measured in radians is called CGS system, sexagesimal system, MKS system, and circular system. So, dear students, it will be circular system. You know that in case of radian, we have circular system. 20 degree is converted into minutes by multiplying with 60. So 20 into 60 is 1200 minutes. Correct option is C. 3 pi over 4 radians. Here you can have pi is equal to 180 degree. Remember that 3 pi over 4 radian means 3 into 180 over 4. And this will be 135 degree. Correct option is B. If tangent theta is equal to 3 under root, then theta is equal to 60 degree. Your correct option is C. You can check even your value with the help of calculator. After that, secant square theta. Secant square theta, this was the fundamental identity. I told you this fundamental identity in exercise 7.4. So secant square theta is 1 plus tangent square theta. That is your correct option is B. Similarly, part number 7 is 1 over 1 plus sine plus 1 over 1 minus sine. Remember that. And you can take LCM and you will find that we will have 1 plus 1 whole divided by 1 minus sine square, and 1 minus sine square is cos square. So 2 over cos square means 2 secant square theta. So 2 secant square theta, your correct option is A. After that we have part number 8. 1 over 2 cosecant 45 degree. Remember that 1 over 2 cosecant 45 degree. Remember that cosecant mean 1 over sine 45. 1 over 2, 1 over 2 under root. Remember that sine 45, cos 45, that is same. 1 over 2 under root. It becomes reciprocal and we are left with 2 under root over 2. And you know that 2 is upside and it will be double inside the square root sign. So this is cancelled out. 1 over 2 under root. Your correct option is 1 over 2 under root. That is B option. Dear students, part number 9. We have secant theta, cotangent theta. Remember that. What about secant theta? Secant theta, cotangent theta. Secant theta, cotangent theta. You know what about secant theta? 1 over cos theta. And cotangent theta is cos theta over sine theta. Cos theta cancelled out. 1 over sine theta. Your correct option is 1 over sine theta. This is C option is correct. After that, part number 10. Cosecant square minus cotangent square. Cosecant square minus cotangent square. You know that we have cosecant square. Cosecant square theta minus cotangent square theta. You know that. What about cosecant square theta? Cosecant square theta is 1 plus cotangent square theta.
minus potential square theta, they are cancelled out. We are left with 1. So your correct option is 1.
So dear students, that was your question number 1, miscellaneous exercise, part number 10. After that, question number 3, fill in the blanks. Pi radian is equal to 180 degrees. The terminal side of angle 235 lies in which quadrant? Definitely, it will be in between 180 and 270, that is in third quadrant. Terminal side of angle minus 30 lies in, actually this will, we will rotate clockwise and it will be between 0 and minus 90, that is fourth quadrant. Area of sector is half r square theta. So if r is equal to 2, theta is equal to 3 radian, then area of sector is half r square theta. Definitely you will apply the formula a is equal to half r square theta, that is formula 1 over 2 into 2 square into 3. So 2 to cancel, it will be 6. So your correct option is 6 centimeter square. The general form of angle is 480 is, actually we have 2n pi plus theta. So if n is equal to 1, 2 pi plus theta, 2 pi means 360. 2 pi means 360, and in case of 480, if you add 480, yes, n is equal to 1, then this will be 480, 0, 2 and 1. So definitely you can check 360 plus 360 plus 120, that is 480. So you can have 2n pi plus 120, where n is equal to 1. So this is general form of 480 degrees. If sine theta is 1 over 2, then theta is equal to sine inverse 1 over 2, and remember that sine inverse 1 over 2 is 30 degrees. If theta is equal to 300, then secant theta is minus 300. Remember that we have a formula. Dear students, we have formula cos minus theta is equal to cos theta. And secant is opposite of cos. So that's why if we have secant minus 300, it will be secant plus 300. 1 plus potential square is fundamental identity, that is cosecant square. And tenth is part secant minus tangent. We have secant theta minus tangent theta. Minus tangent theta. Remember, secant is 1 over cos theta. Minus tangent is sine theta over cos theta. You can have cos theta LCM, 1 minus sine theta. So dear students, this will be 1 minus sine theta over cos theta. That was your part number 10. I hope that you understood this question and you will do it, inshallah. Okay, Allah Hafiz, and assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.